Welcome sa ating YouTube channel. Ang topic natin sa video na ito ay about sa Method of Consistent Deformation for Structures with Multiple Degrees of Indeterminacy. So for our past 3 videos, meron tayong video for truss, beams, and frames with single degree of indeterminacy. For this one, more than 1 degree of indeterminacy yung solve natin. So for our first example, determine the moments at the supports of the fixed beam shown. So we have a concentrated load P at distance A from the left support and distance B from the right support. Take note that the sum of A and B is equal to L. The assumed direction of MA is counterclockwise and MC clockwise. So we have 2 degrees of indeterminacy here. Bakit po, sir? Kasi obviously, AX and CX here should be equal to 0 because wala namang presence ng horizontal loading. Therefore, sobra tayo ng dalawang reactions. Para mabilis yung ating solution, we're going to take itself, the moments, as the redundance. So, MA and MC as the redundance. Okay? So, yung ating magiging primary beam ay magiging simple supported beam. Okay, from statics, this is our resultant or reaction at the supports. So, dahil ginawa mo siyang simple supported beam, magkakaroon ng deflection yung beam natin. Just like this. Hindi po yan sakto pero most likely ganyan. Ang punto dito, magkakaroon ng slope dito sa point A. Tatawagin natin itong theta prime A at yung sa kabila, theta prime C naman. Okay? Next. Maglalagay tayo ng unit load 1 na counterclockwise sa point A. Okay? Times MA, guys, no? Para maging equal siya dun sa mismong magnitude ng MA. Take note that the assumption of MA dun kanina sa original figure natin ay counterclockwise. So, counterclockwise din yung unit moment na 1 dito. So, dahil counterclockwise to, kailangan i-resist siya ng clockwise na couple. So, that is 1 over L. Distance between the supports is L. So, clockwise yung moment niyan. So, magkakaroon tayo ng deflected shape like this. So, magkakaroon ng slope dito. So, this is read as follows. The slope at point A due to the load applied at point A, yun yung theta AA, and dito naman, this is theta CA. This is the slope at point C due to the load applied at point A. Okay? So next, doon tayo sa MC. So mag-apply tayo ngayon ng clockwise moment na 1 at point C. Take note, clockwise yung moment sa original na figure natin, no, yung assumption doon. So dapat counterclockwise yung rotation ng reactions. Nevertheless, concerned tayo rin sa deflected shape at yung sa slope at the ends. So, this is the slope at A due to the external loading or due to the load 1 applied at point C, and this is the slope at point C due to the load applied at point C. Okay? So, for our compatibility equation, take note that the sum of these 3, theta prime A, theta AA, and theta AC should be equal to 0 kasi wala namang rotation dun sa original no figure natin. So, as with this one, theta prime C plus theta CA plus theta CC is equal to 0. Okay, saan po ba equal yung theta AA, theta AC, theta CA, at theta CC? This equal to what? Okay, theta AA is equal to what? FAA times MA. Theta AC is FAC times MC. Okay, so as with this one, pansinin nyo parehas yung mga subscript. Sir, ano po yung F? That is called flexibility coefficient. Take note that flexibility is the reciprocal of stiffness. Okay, so saan po equal yan? Okay, so alamin muna natin yung mga basic na formula natin sa theory of structures. So, pwede kang gumamit ng area moment method, double integration method, conjugate beam method, or even virtual work method to solve the slopes. Okay? So, for theta prime A, we have PB over 6EI times the quantity L squared minus B squared. Sir, bakit po negative? Kasi kung papansinin natin yung rotation sa point A, okay, counterclockwise is positive. Okay? But since clockwise yung theta prime A, kaya negative yung magnitude niya. Okay? For theta prime C, same lang halos, palitan mo lang yung B ng A. So, PA over 6EI L times the quantity L squared minus A squared. Bakit din po negative? Kasi kung titignan natin yung applied moment at point C na clockwise, salungat naman itong theta prime C na counterclockwise, no? Kaya negative din. Mahalaga po yung magnitude, no? So, punta tayo dito sa upper left part natin. So, saan naman equal yung FAA tsaka FCA? Okay, using area moment method or any moment or any method na magkuha ng slope, makukuha natin yung L over 3EI for FAA and then L over 6EI for FCA. Take note that the unit load 1 here is applied. Wala yung multiply by MA. So, therefore, this is just a flexibility coefficient. Then, likewise, FAC is equal to L over 6EI and then FCC is equal to L over 3EI. Okay? So, guys, nagkataon lang na parehas yung FAA tsaka FCC, no? Hindi po laging parehas yan. Pero, palaging parehas itong FCA tsaka FAC. Kung papansinin ninyo, nagka-breaked lang yung subscript. Palaging equal yan. Later on, malalaman natin kung ano yung reason behind that, no? So, plug in natin lahat ng mga values na to sa ating compatibility equation. So, this one plus FAA, which is L over 3EI, plus FAC. Okay? Time, that is L over 6EI equal to 0. Lagay lang natin lahat. Okay? So, multiply natin ng 6EI over L para ma-simplify ng konti to become this one. Then, by transposing the constant at the other side of the equation, for both equations, magiging ganito siya. So, to eliminate moment at C, times natin ng 2 itong equation na to, yung first equation natin, para maging ganito. So, that if we subtract the first or if we subtract the second equation from the first equation, magka-cancel yung 2MC. So, 4MA minus MA is equal to what? 3MA. Okay? So, let us simplify the right-hand terms. Okay? Same lang L squared or same ng denominator, L squared. Factoring out P over L squared, magiging ganito siya. Okay? Distribution. Take note that L is equal to A plus B. So, yung nasa loob ng ating group na terms, papalitan natin yung L ng A plus B. Okay? And then, expanding. And then, distributing again to B. And then, A dun sa both terms. Magiging ganito siya. Okay? So, it deals with algebra, guys. So, if you notice, magka-cancel yung 2B cube. So, as with A cube. So, as with 2A squared B. And, ano yung natitira dito? Itong 4AB squared minus AB squared. So, 4 minus 1 is 3. Become the equation or the term inside the group parentheses is equal to what? 3AB squared. So, to get MA, divide natin ng 3 to become what? PAB squared over L squared. Positive po yung nakuha natin. Ibig sabihin, tama yung assumption ng direction ng MA. So, napakahalaga po ng formula na to. Okay? Mapa-college man kayo mag-take ng board exam, napakahalaga na ito. Magagamit pa natin sa mga ating susunod na videos. Okay? So, balik tayo rin sa ating original equations. Nakuha na natin yung MA. Doon naman tayo sa MC. So, para ma-eliminate naman yung MA, multiply natin yung second equation ng 2 para maging ganito. So, para mas madali yung simplification, let us switch them, no? So, that subtract the second equation from the first equation para mag-cancel yung 2MA. So, 4 minus 1 is 3. So, you have 3MC is equal to what? This long terms. Okay? So, kagaya ng ginawa natin kanina, over L squared, factoring out P over L squared, distribution, and again, note that L is equal to A plus B. Palitan natin yan, expand natin, and then distributing. Halos parehas lang yan sa kanina. Nagkapalit lang ng position yung A tsaka yung B. Okay, take note, 2A cube magka-cancel out. Ano pa? B cube magka-cancel out. Ano pa pong magka-cancel out dito? Ayan, yung 2AB squared. So, ano matitira? 4A squared B minus A squared B. So, 4 minus 1 is 3 also. So, ito naman 3A squared B. Cancel out 3 for both sides. Therefore, MC is equal to what? PA squared B over L squared. Okay, napaka-vital ng mga formula na itong na-derive natin, no? Okay. So, tapos na tayo sa beams, no? Punta na tayo sa frames. Okay, determine the reactions of the frame shown. So, meron tayong fixed support at point A and then a roller at point C, also at point D. So, kahit fixed support lang to, stable na siya, tsaka determinate. So, dahil sobra tayo ng dalawang reactions, so, tanggalin natin yung ibang mga reactions dito. We have AV, RC, RD, syempre may AH dito. Then, meron ding moment para kumpleto. Okay? So, for simplicity ng ating solution, we are going to choose the reactions at point C and D sa rollers and C at C and D as our redundants. So, pag tinanggal natin yan, magiging free end yung point D. Okay? So, tanggalin natin sila na. So, ito yung magiging ating primary frame subjected to external loading. Okay? So, dahil walang vertical forces na involved, so, zero yon yung vertical reaction dito. 6 times 40 kilonewton per meter or 6 meters times 40 kilonewton per meter. Basic lang yan. 240 kilonewtons. So, how about the moment? Okay, compute natin yan, no? So, we have what? 40 times 6 times 3. That is 720 na clockwise. We have 120 na counterclockwise. So, ibawas natin. Yan. So, 600 kilonewton meter. Okay? So, let's say this is the deflected shape of this frame. Take note, ang tinanggal natin ay rollers at point C and D. So, dahil tinanggal natin sila, nagkaroon ng deflection at point C and point D. Okay, tatawagan natin silang delta prime C plus delta prime D. Okay? So, next tayo. Mag-apply tayo ngayon ng unit load 1 at point C. So, assumed natin na direction ng RC ay pataas, no? So, this entire system times RC, we will get the magnitudes, no? Eh, di pa natin alam yung RC, so okay lang na 1 unit load pa lang ito. Okay? So, syempre, walang horizontal force ngayon, so 0 ito. To resist 1, kailangan may pababang 1 dito. And 1 times distance na 4 meters. So, ito yung ating magiging reactions at point A. Let's say this is the deflected shape of this frame. So, magkakaroon tayo ng deflection again at points C and D. But this time around, tatawagin natin tong delta CC. Ano pong ibig sabihin nito? This is the deflection at point C due to the load applied at point C. Okay? And this one is delta DC, which is the deflection at point D due to the load applied at point C. Okay? So now, lagay naman natin yung unit load sa point D. So, ang mangyayari dito, nabago lang naman yung moment arm ng 1. So, 8 meters na yun. So, 1 times 8 is 8 meters. Okay? So, this is the deflected shape of the frame. This one naman ay delta CD, which is the deflection of point C due to the load applied at point D. And obviously, this is what? The deflection at point D due to the load applied at point D. Okay? So, meron tayong times RD, no? Kung ano man yung value ng RD. Okay? So, let us determine the moment equations na gagamitin natin. Okay? Ito yung mga reactions natin, no? So, dito sa point B, sa BCD, 120 kilonewton meter na clockwise. So, ipapasa natin siya na counterclockwise. Dito. So, tama, no? Equilibrium yan, guys, no? Kasi kanina nakuha natin yung moment ng uniformly distributed load na 720. Bawas natin yung 600, magiging 120. Okay. So, ngayon magpas tayo ng cutting plane dito sa segment AB. Consider natin yung upper portion so that our origin is point B. Kasi mas konti yung forces na involved. Okay. So, this is the assumed direction of the moment. This is distance x. So, we have what? M minus 120 plus 40x times the moment arm na kalahati ng x. X over 2 equals 0. So, we have what? M is equal to 120 minus 20x squared. Okay? So, now, magpapas tayo ngayon ng cutting plane at segment BC. Take note guys, no BC. Okay, magkahiwalay na segment kasi yan. Kasi mamaya merong unit load 1 dun sa point C. Kaya we are forced to cut it into 2. Okay? So, consider natin yung left portion. Okay, this is the assumed direction of the moment. This is distance x. So, m minus 120 is equal to 0. So, m is equal to 120. Okay? So, now, consider naman natin yung segment CD. Okay? But this time around, consider natin yung right portion. Okay? This is the assumed direction of the moment. This is distance x. And m minus 120 is equal to 0. So, m is equal to 120. Okay? Please take note of these values. Now, punta tayo rin sa isang figure natin. Yun yung merong unit load 1 at point C. So, here are the reactions. Okay? So, para balance, yung 4 na moment dito counterclockwise, pasa natin dito as clockwise, so as with 1, no? So, balance siya, guys, no? So, just like what we did din sa unang figure natin, magpas tayo ng cutting plane here. Consider natin na point B as origin. This is MC. Take note, no? That MC, kasi mamaya meron pa tayong moment for D. This is distance X. So, MC is equal to 4. Okay? So, next, segment BC tayo. This is MC. So, we have what? This is distance X. So, we have MC minus 4. Plus 1 times x is equal to 0. So, mc is equal to 4 minus x. Kay CD naman, pasay ng cutting plane. This is mc. This is distance x. Obviously, mc here is equal to 0. Take note of these values. Now, lipat natin yung unit load sa point D. So, just like this one, katulad nung kanina, self-explanatory na to, nagbago lang dito yung moment. So, pas tayo ng cutting plane, this MD, is distance x. So obvious naman to, MD is equal to 8. For this one, pasayin ng cutting plane here. This is MD. This is distance x. Obviously, ang nagbago lang dito yung moment na 8. No? And then, for segment CD, this is MD. This is distance x. MD is equal to 1 times x, or simply x. Okay? For our compatibility condition, we have delta prime C plus delta prime or delta CC plus delta CD is equal to 0. Delta prime D plus delta DC plus delta DD is equal to 0. Just like what we did a while ago, this will be equal to what? Delta CC is equal to what? FCC times the magnitude of RC. Then delta CD is equal to FCD times RD. And then so as with this one, where F is the flexibility coefficient. So saan naman equal tong mga values na to? Okay, that will be equal to what? The summation of integral of MMC over EI dx for delta prime C. For delta prime D, mababago lang yung moment. MD. FCC is equal to what? MC times MC. Magiging MC rin kasi yung yung capital M, no? So, this is simply equal to what? Summation of the integral of MC squared over EI dx. For FDD, ilang din. Summation of the integral of MD squared over EI dx. FCD is MC times MD over EI dx, and FDC is equal to what? Summation of MD times MC over EI dx. What did you notice here? Parehas yung FCD tsaka FDC. Yun yung sinasabi ko kanina, no? Equal sila. And this is by means of what we call the Betty's law. Okay? So, alam niyo yung ibig sabihin ng Betty's law, no? Actually, Betty's law states that the deflection of point J due to the loading applied at point I is equal to the deflection of I due to the load applied at point J. So, yun po ibig sabihin nun, no? So, mag-prepare tayo ng table. Take note that our origins is BBD for AB, BC, and CD. Limits is 0 to 6, 0 to 4, and 0 to 4. Ilagay natin yung mga moment equations na nakuha natin. Okay? Okay. So, meron tayong calculator dito, no? So, we have what? The first one is integral of 120 minus 20 x squared. Okay, times 8 from 0 to 6. We have negative 5,760. Ah, sorry. Times 4 po pala, no? Ayan, negative 2,880. Nagkamali lang po ng type, no? Okay? So, next is equal to what? This is equal to 120 times 4 minus x from 0 to 4. This is 960. And this one, obviously, 0 to. Okay? So, bawasan natin ng 2,880. So, yun yung sum nilang dalawa. Negative 1 takas sa 920 over EI. Okay? So, ito yung namali kong pindot kanina, no? Ito. So, 120 minus 20x squared times 8. Yun yung negative 5,760. So, next, 120 times 8 minus x. So, ito na napapalitan ko, no? So, we have 2,880 over EI. And then, we have 120 times x. This is 960. And get the sum. Plus 2,880 minus 5,760. We have negative 1,920 over EI. Next, yung column ng MC squared. We have integral of what? 4 squared over EI from 0 to 6. This is 96 over EI. Next, the integral of 4 minus x from 0 to 4. You have 64 over 3 EI. This one, obviously, 0. So, kunin natin yung sum, plus 96. We have 352 over 3 EI. Next, for MD, integral of 8 squared from 0 to 6. We have 384 over EI. Next one is integral of 8 minus x from 0 to 4. We have 448 over 3 EI, and the integral of x squared from 0 to 4 is 64 over 3 EI. Add natin, plus 448 over 3, plus 384. We have 1,664 over 3 EI. For our last column, we have the integral of 4 times 8 from 0 to 6. We have 192 over EI. Next is the integral of 4 minus x times 8 minus x from 0 to 4. We have 160 over 3 EI. And obviously this is 0 plus 192. We have 736 over 3 EI. Okay? So, plug it into our compatibility equation. We have negative 1,920 over EI plus 352 over 3 EI times RC plus 736 over 3 EI times RD equal to 0. Okay? The other equation is negative 1,920 over EI plus 736 over 3 EI times RC plus 1,664 over 3 EI times RD equal to 0. If you notice, common yung over EI, cancel natin. Okay? Transpose natin, and then multiply natin ng 3 both equations para matanggal yung denominator. So, ito yung ating magiging bagong or simplified na equations. So, we have 2 equations, 2 unknowns. So, gamit tayo ng 2 equations, 2 unknowns. No, 352, 736, 5760, 736, 1664, then 5760. So, we have what? 5,220 over 43 and negative 2,160 over 43. Okay? So, kinuha ko na yung approximate values. So, RC is equal to 121.395 kilonewtons and RD is equal to what? Negative 50.233 kilonewtons. Ano pong ibig sabihin ng sign? Okay, for RC, kaya positive siya, tama yung assumption ng direction. On the other hand, sa RD, negative siya dahil baliktad yung assumption natin. So, pababa talaga yung RD. Nevertheless, yung pagkuha ng remaining reactions, kailangan natin yung magnitude ng mga values na to. Solving for the remaining reactions, we have AH is equal to negative 240, AV is equal to negative 71.163 kilonewtons, and MA is equal to negative 516.279 kilonewton meter. Take note that these values are the reactions doon sa ating external, yung 240 and negative 600, rather negative 240 and negative 600, yan yung reactions dun sa primary frame due to external loading. And then, likewise, yung iba naman dyan for with redundancy MC, RC and RD. So, for this problem, lagay natin yung mga values. Negative 71.163 for AV. Ito yung mga nakuha natin kanina, no? With their corresponding directions, AH is negative 214, walang duda yan. At yung moment ay 516.279 kilonewton meter. Okay? For our last problem, we have a truss as shown. Determine the reactions and the forces in each member of the trusses shown. So, ito yung ating mga reactions, no? AV, RC, AH, saka RD. So, pipili tayo ng isang reaction dito kasi sobra lang siya ng isang reaction. And then, notice natin merong cross-brace dito. So, pipili tayo ng isang redundant na member. So, this is externally indeterminate first degree, but first degree din siya na indeterminate internally. So, pipili tayo ng isang reaction tsaka isang member. Pero, kailangan statically determinate pa rin siya. So, we're going to choose RC and force at member BD as the redundant. Okay. So, for the primary truss, subjected to external loading. So, yung vertical reaction sa hinge ay negative 100. Dito naman sa RD. Okay. So, take note yung dimensions na horizontal 4 meters. Sa vertical 3 meters. So, we have what? Balik tayo na mode 1 na. 100 times 4 meters divided by 3 meters na moment arm ng D sa A. This is what? 400 over 3 or 133.33. Siyempre, going to the left para kontra yung rotation. And then, 133.333 dito naman. Pakana naman siya. So, by method of joints, kailangan makuha natin yung mga forces with indications ng kanilang nature, kung compression or tension. So, meron tayong mga zero force members dito. Okay? Next is the primary truss subjected to redundant RC. So, naglagay tayo ng unit load 1 na pataas dito sa point C. So, yung vertical reaction dito ay 1. So, 1 times 8 divided by 3 meters. So, this is what? 2.667. Okay? Ito naman going to the right. So, ito naman going to the left para makontra sila na. Then, again, by method of joints, kunin natin yung mga forces at each members. The next, subjected naman sa force BD. So, in-assume natin na tension yung force sa BD. Hindi natin alam yan na mamaya subject to checking yan. So, syempre dahil concurrent yung dalawang yan, wala mai-induce na reaction sa supports. So, by method of joints, again, kunin natin yung mga bar forces. Okay, here are as follows. Okay, so alam na natin kung paano kunin yung compatibility equation, no? So, this is what? Delta prime C plus delta prime CC. This is what? The deflection at point C due to the load at point C. And what? Delta C BD, which is the deflection at C due to the load applied at BD, should be equal to 0. Dito din sa BD. So, the deflection at PD plus deflection, okay, of BD with applied load at C plus the deflection at BD due to the applied load at BD should be equal to 0. So, using the relationship for their compatibility or for their flexibility coefficients, so here are as follows. Okay, so saan naman equal tong mga to? Okay, so si delta prime C is equal to kay Sulae. So, lalagyan lang natin ng subscript na C yung kay U kasi meron din tayo para kay BD. Okay? So, FCC is equal to UC times UC. So, UC squared times L over AE. Sa BD naman, so UBD squared L over AE. CCD naman or CC due to kay BD is UC times UBD times L over AE. Ganun din kay BD. Kama C. So, UBD times UC times L over AE. Again, ito yung sinasabi ko kanina. Parehas yung dalawang yan by means of Betty's law. Okay? So, mag-prepare tayo ng table. Okay? Ilagay natin yung mga cross-sectional areas. Yun yung mga nakaparetesis dun sa original na figure. Ilagay natin yung mga lengths. Okay? Then, ilagay natin carefully yung mga values doon sa members. Okay? Pero pwede rin natin ilagay yung para sa mga reactions. Okay? So, if you notice, may mga cells dito sa S, UC, tsaka UBD na 0. Therefore, multiplication by 0 is equal to 0. So, lalagay na natin yung mga cells na may mga 0. Take note, hindi na natin sinama rito yung modulus of elasticity kasi constant naman siya. Okay, later on, magka-cancel out din naman yun, no? Okay, let us compute the following. Okay? We have what? Lagay natin dito na. Okay, we have 133.333 times negative 2.667 times L na 4,000 divided by A na 5,000. Okay, this is 284.479 roughly. Nilagay ko po yung sakto dito na kasi may exact values yung 133.333 at negative 2.667. Maganda tong gawin sa Excel. Okay, papakita ko lang dito yung first columns, no? Then this one is negative 166.667 times 1.667 times L na 5,000 divided by 4,000 na area. So, 347.29. Ilagay natin yung sakto. 347.222. Okay? So, sum up natin. This will yield to negative 631.667. Okay? So, as with this one, 133.333 times negative 0.8 times 3,000 divided by 4,000. Okay. Negative. Okay. Nasaan na tayo? Okay. Tingnan nga natin. Negative 85 na. Okay. So, 4,000 po pala ito. Gamali tayo ng tingin. Yan. Okay, 133.333 times negative 0.8 times 4,000 divided by 5,000. And negative 85.33. And then this one, yung sa AE naman, is negative 166.667 times 1 times length na 5,000 divided by area na 4,000. So, 208.333. Okay, sum up natin, negative 338.667. So, this is just a practice on your part. Pwede lang kayo yung kumuha. Ilalagay na lang natin yung mga values. Okay? Mas maganda to kung naka-Excel, guys, no? Para sakto yung mga values. Mas ma-appreciate nyo siya kapag ginawa nyo siya ng spreadsheet. Okay? So, ayan. So, ang mahalaga dito, makuha mo ng sakto itong mga to, yung mga sum. Kasi yun yung kailangan natin dun na sa substitute sa mga compatibility equation natin. So, delta prime C is equal to what? Negative 631.667 over E. Take note, hindi natin sinama yung E, no? So, ilalagay natin siya rin sa original na equation. Si delta prime BD is negative 338.667 over E. FCC is 14.7833 over E. BD is equal to what? Positive 4.064 over E. And FC, BD is equal to what? FBD, C, which is equal to what? Positive 2.9367 over E. So, plugging it to our compatibility equation, we have this one and this one. If you notice, for both equations, magka-cancel out yung E. So, tanggalin natin. Okay, and then transposing the constant sa kabilang side. Okay, and then gamitan natin ng calculator. Okay, we have 14.7833. Okay, 2.9367. Gawin natin yung ganyan, no? 631.667, 2.9367, 4.064, then 338.667. We have 30.561. Okay? And then, 61.25 for FBD. So, parehas positive. Ibig sabihin, yung assumption natin ng mga direction nila. Okay? Solving for the forces. So, nandito naman yung formula natin. So, we have what? Okay, negative 8.251, 40.748, and so on and so forth. Okay, then so as for the reactions, applicable din to na kagaya naman ginawa natin sa first part natin. Okay, so here are the values. So, to plug it into our original truss, so ito yung mga nakuha natin na unknowns, 30.561, pataas yan, and then 61.25 kay BD na tension. Kasi positive siya kanina. For the reactions, is 51.837, 69.439, going to the left and upward respectively, and then this one is 51.837 na pakaliwa. So, ito yung mga nakuha natin na values. You can check it on your own by means of method of joints kung tama yung ating mga nakuhang values. Okay po ba yan, guys? So, I would like to take the opportunity to promote our book, which is Civil Engineering Twilight. An Engineering Mathematics and Applied Sciences review book consists of the following subjects: algebra, geometry, trigonometry, including vectors, differential and integral calculus with differential equations, probability and statistics, engineering economy, mechanics, yung statics and dynamics, physics, and strength of materials. So it has a conventional solution and an alternate solution to selected problems. For more inquiries, please visit our Facebook page, Civil Engineering Twilight, or facebook.com/CETwilight. So, ano pang iniintay nyo, guys? Grab a copy now. Please don't forget to subscribe and hit the notification bell. Thank you very much.